Hello, my dear friends. How are you? Myself is Professor Dr. Rajendra Deshpande, and I welcome you in this serial regarding the medicine in our medical general practice. My dear friends, today's topic is indigestion. So, as you know, we have started with the digestive tract problems in medical general practice presented by myself, that is Professor Dr. Deshpande, MD in Ayurvedic Medicine and also MD in Ayurvedic Physiology. My dear friends, you are welcome with this my WhatsApp number 9226810630. Now next, this is my new mail ID, professordeshpande@gmail.com. You can contact me on this mail for personal or online health problem advice, personal or online lifestyle counseling, based on your prakriti and palmistry, personal or online classes of medicine and Ayurveda, of course all the subjects of Ayurveda. We are talking about digestive system problems in GP. So there are many problems, like I can say these are not the diseases, these are the complaints: anorexia, indigestion, aerophagy or the gas problem, gas in the stomach, stomatitis, hiccup, constipation, diarrhea. Then there is a vomiting, dysphagia, pain in abdomen, irritable bowel syndrome, jaundice and peptic ulcer. Today we are specifically concentrating on the indigestion problem. In Ayurveda, this indigestion is called as ajirna or agnimandya. Ajirna is an acute condition of indigestion and agnimandya is a basic pathology which can run for years together. As I already told you, you may practice Ayurveda, allopathy, homeopathy, naturopathy, but you must be able to make the differential diagnosis of the disease or a perfect cause. Because after finding the cause only, you can treat the particular condition. So what are the causes of indigestion as an organic problem? There may be abnormalities of esophagus, stomach or duodenum. There may be cardiospasm at the end, basic end of the esophagus near the stomach. There may be the tumor of the esophagus. There may be diaphragmatic hernia, acrohydria, very rarely, gastritis, peptic ulcer, and maybe carcinoma of stomach. We go further. We are trying to find out the causes of indigestion. So let us take history, proper history, whether there is a reflex dyspepsia. Reflex dyspepsia. So cause is at the another site. For example, due to the diseases of appendix, like appendicitis, chronic appendicitis, there may be problem in the gallbladder, pancreas or intestine. This is a repetition of your appendicitis. Then cholecystitis. Cholecystitis, as you know, inflammation of the gallbladder, pancreatitis, amoebiasis, very common in the Indian population, sprue, spastic colon, intestinal worms, and especially you must take care of the giardiasis, whether this can be the cause of indigestion. We will go further. We are trying to find our diagnosis perfect. We just look for systemic diseases, whether there is any heart problem like CCF, congestive cardiac failure, whether their patient is suffering from pulmonary tuberculosis, whether the patient's hemoglobin and RBC is low, he is suffering from anemia, and that may be the root cause of indigestion. Uremia may be the problem. Hyperparathyroidism may be the problem of indigestion. And all these are the physical causes. Now we will talk about psychological, mental or functional causes. There may be faulty habit of eating, nervous exhaustion, anxiety, or there may be depression. Now, how you can confirm your provisional diagnosis? We all people, we doctors, make the provisional diagnosis at a clinical level, that is called as a clinical diagnosis. Then there are now a lot of biophysical and biochemical developments. So even Ayurvedic and homeopathic people should not hesitate to take the help of investigations. Although it is outdated, there in the previous olden days, gastric analysis was very common, which was done for achlorhydria. That means less amount of hydrochloric acid, a chlorohydrion. Stool examination, past and present and future, it will be the common, it is common. It is for cyst, ova or incomplete digestive matter. It can also find out occult blood, hidden blood due to the some ulcer in the GI tract. Then you must go for urine routine examination and also renal function test. Basically there are two. One is blood urea and serum creatinine. So that can give you the idea about the patient's chronic kidney failure and may be suffering from uremia. Now this is very fundamental and basic investigation for each and every chronic condition. This is hemogram, hemoglobin, RBC count, WBC count, differential count, and also the morphology of RBC. ESR is rule out, especially ESR is not for acute, I'm sorry to say, but this is for chronic infection like tuberculosis. LFT, liver function test, to rule out liver problems, like it may be jaundice, it may be cirrhosis, whatsoever. Then chest X-ray is also very interesting to rule out the pox or the tuberculosis patients. Then ECG, basic investigation, to rule out the cardiac pathology, for example, right ventricular failure or left ventricular failure. Then abdominal ultrasonography to check the abdominal pathology, such as the tumor anywhere in the abdomen. Now, this is very interesting to note the point. Indigestion word is used by the patient in many aspects, and doctor's duty is to exact get what he is meant by indigestion. Patient always say, oh doctor, I am having full in my stomach, I am having the gas, I am having the constipation, this and that. All they make it as indigestion, okay? So first you should rule out whether there is a loss of appetite. Loss of appetite suggests if it is a short duration, say for a week, then it can be infective hepatitis. If it is a long run, 6 months loss of appetite, lot of loss of weight, evening rise of temperature, cough, it may be the case of pox or tuberculosis. Then, when the patient say indigestion, ask him whether you have the nausea or vomiting type of symptoms. Nausea and vomiting is seen in the hepatitis as well as during the pregnancy, first 2-3 months. Then ask the patient, when you say indigestion, what is meant? It is a belching or is it aerophagy? Is it a constipation? Is it a diarrhea? Is it a bad looking stool? Or is it passing gases per rectum? There are the different types of shades in indigestion, and you have to be pinpointed what type of the complaint the patient is suffering from. Now indigestion, okay? Is it a burning chest in the or with water brush? It may be the case of esophageal reflex, it may be the case of gastritis, it may be the case of peptic ulcer. Now, we will come to the treatment part. First, of course, everywhere you have to be very cautious about the cause. Unless and until you take care of the causative factor, etiological factor, you cannot treat the patient completely. Okay? But still, we have to treat symptomatically. That is very essential for general medical practice. We are not the consultants. We are not in the hospitals. So what you can suggest as a home remedy? Lemon juice with salt, with sugar, with hot water. It's like a sarbat, lemon juice sarbat. Okay? Then Vagbhata, Ayurvedic scientist, has mentioned wet ginger with 1 centimeter or one very small piece of ginger with little bit salt before meals. Every day, lunch and dinner, it can stimulate your appetite. Then, to treat the indigestion, gas, very interesting tablet from Himalaya company, that is GasX. GasX, 2 tablets, 3 times in a day, 2 tablets morning, 2 tablets afternoon, 2 tablets evening, after meal, okay? Or you can, in spite of GasX, you can use Shankhavati, 2 tablets, 3 times in a day. I forgot here all, GasX or Shankhavati, remember. Then there is a Hingvashtak Churna. This is also all. You can select one of these, whichever the available nearby or whichever the doctor has a confidence about that medicine. So hingvashtak churna, hing is aisa phitida. There are 8 ingredients in that churna or the powder. Half teaspoon 3 times in a day with ghee and warm water. Here sometimes the tablets are also available. Hingvashtak churna vati may be available in the market of Chaitanya Pharmaceutical. Then either you use Gasex or Shankavati or Hingvashtak churna. I will suggest at night, if there is a little bit unsatisfactory bowel, Trifala tablet is very good. Trifala tablet, one tablet with the warm water at bedtime. Warm water is very essential for indigestion. Next, another formulations, another drugs. Ama Pachakavati, Ayurvedic drugs. 2 tablets 3 times in a day, or tablet Arogya Vardhini Vati from Baidyanath or Ayurveda Sashala, 2 tablets 3 times in a day. And what can be the carrier with which material this tablet should be given? What is a tablet? Remember, Ayurveda has says this is anupana. Anupana. Okay? So panchakolaso is a liquid. Panchakolaso from Sandhu Pharmaceuticals. 4 teaspoon with the equal amount of water with these tablets we have to give. Then patient has completed his problems of acute indigestion. But we feel after some disease, we feel that indigestion should not recur. It should not come again and again. Or we want to treat as a prophylaxis beforehand. Then what can be the medicines? Agni Kumar Rasa, 1 tablet per day only after breakfast. Or Agni Tundi Vati, 1 tablet per day after breakfast. Or Lashunadi Vati, 1 tablet per day. These are all the 3 medicines, either or. Remember, not all the medicines together, because all these medicines are very, very hot. So Pitta Prakriti people should be very careful while taking the medicines, because this Lashunadi, Lashun is a garlic. So very careful about this hot medicine from Ayurveda. Now, this is very important, indigestion and lifestyle. First, you must follow the Ayurvedic rules of eating. I think there are different terms. I will discuss all these terms afterwards. But just have a look on that. Ayurveda says there are rules of eating. They are the topics like, for example, Ashtau Ahara Vidhi Visheshayatana. And one of that topic is Ahara Vidhi Vidhana. Ahara Vidhi Vidhana means rules of food eating. Ahara Vidhi Vidhana. Why I am saying this all very simple and repeatedly? So that you can write down these words in your notebook. Am I right? So this is another major of lifestyle. Intermittent fasting. Intermittent fasting. Not every day. Once in a week, once in a fortnight. But again, it will depend on Prakruti. Kapha Prakruti people can tolerate fasting, but typical pitta predominant people may not tolerate total fasting. So they can take the soup juices, they can light a diet like mung, like a green gram khichdi or green gram soup, vegetable soups, fruit juices. Okay. Be regular in diet and have the fresh warm food in moderation as per the hunger. This is very important. When you are hungry, then only you should eat. Otherwise, it will be indigestion. Stay away from sleeplessness or overexertion. So, mental and physical adequate rest is very essential. Don't go to the sleep at midnight. That is very bad for indigestion. Avoid fast food or eating outside many times. Frequency should be reduced. Once in a while, everything is accepted. But don't make it a habit of hotel eating. That is different. Cooking at home and eating at a hotel, definitely it makes some difference. Okay? Make sure that you have at least one of these Indian spices, coriander, ginger, lemon, black pepper, as per your constitution. Okay? Avoid day sleep, diva swap in Ayurveda. And also avoid the sleep as soon as you complete your food. That means coming from the dining table and going to the bed. That is very bad for the indigestion. Indigestion and yoga. So these are the different postures that you can follow under the guidance of yoga teacher. उड्डियान बंध फॉर इंडाइजेशन, वज्रासन प्रैक्टिस ऑफ वज्रासन इन इंडाइजेशन, उष्ट्रासन दिस इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट दिस इज वेरी इजी, पवन मुक्तासन वेरी इजी लर्न फ्रॉम द योगा टीचर एंड डू इट पवन बट रिमेंबर ऑल दिस योगा पोस्चर शुड बी डन ऑन एम्प्टी स्टमक एंड विथ लूज क्लोथ्स ओके मत्स्यासन एंड देर इज अ शुद्धि प्रक्रिया डिटॉक्स प्रोसेस इन योगा वन ऑफ दिस कॉल्ड इज नवली बट रिमेंबर आई एम ऑलवेज सेइंग दिस इज नॉट फॉर सेल्फ मेडिकेशन माय दिस वीडियोज आर ऑल ओनली फॉर योगा पर आई एम सॉरी फॉर द एजुकेशनल पर्पज ओके एंड दिस इज द एंड ऑफ आवर इंडाइजेशन टॉपिक माई डियर फ्रेंड्स आई विल टेल यू थ्री सूत्री थ्री वे ऑफ मैनेजमेंट ऑफ एनी डिसीज अकॉर्डिंग टू आयुर्वेद थ्री वेज ऑफ ट्रीटिंग एनी डिसीज आहार विहार एंड औषधि दिस इज अ ट्राइपोड ऑफ द मैनेजमेंट वेदर यू प्रैक्टिस एलोपैथी आयुर्वेद होम्योपैथी नेचुरोपैथी वॉट शुड बी योर मैनेजमेंट पॉलिसी ट्राइपोड आहार एडवाइस अबाउट पथ्य एंड अपथ्य डाइट कंट्रोल विहार लाइफस्टाइल मैनेजमेंट एंड औषधि सो औषधि इज अ लास्ट मेडिकेशन इज अ लास्ट फर्स्ट पथ्य अपथ्य डूज एंड डोंट्स ऑफ फूड डूज एंड डोंट्स ऑफ लाइफस्टाइल आई होप यू आर लाइकिंग माई ऑल दिस वीडियोज प्लीज प्लीज यू हैव ऑलरेडी सब्सक्राइब आई नो बट टेल यूर फ्रेंड्स रिलेटिव्स हूसोएवर यू वॉन्ट टू लर्न आयुर्वेद योग मॉडर्न मेडिसिन आयुर्वेदिक सिलेबस एवरीथिंग वी आर हियर ए लॉट ऑफ वराइटी इवन आई विल स्टार्ट नाउ पामेस्ट्री ओके सो माई डियर फ्रेंड्स डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब माई यूट्यूब चैनल दैट गिव्स मी बूस्ट ऑफ ऑल डूइंग ऑल दिस एक्टिविटी वंस अगेन थैंक यू वेरी मच एंड टेक गुड केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ हैव अ नाइस डे अहेड थैंक यू